going to talk about the emergencies in diabetes mellitus. So what are the emergencies? The commonest cause is hypoglycemia. Hypoglycemia means lower level of blood sugar in the blood than below the normal level. That means below 70 milligram per deciliter in the blood. So what are the causes? Causes means mostly it is due to drug induced. Some patients may take excessive dose of oral tablets without their knowledge, or they take tablet and they skip meals, and then any sickness, example fever, diarrhea, vomiting, like the conditions, that is hypoglycemia. The management is we should take immediately with the high sugar, with the glucose or the sugary drinks or like that. Then another thing is diabetic emergency. Second diabetic emergency is diabetic ketoacidosis. This is exactly opposite of hypoglycemia. This is due to very high level of blood sugar. Blood sugar, example, more than 500 or 600. It leads to so many pathologies in the human body, and it leads to ketosis. Accumulated ketosis, excessive ketones in the blood. So below 7.4, that is called acidosis. Then reduced carbohydrate level in the blood. So that is called diabetic ketoacidosis. So now I am talk about diabetes mellitus, about its cause, complications and management. So diabetes has mainly three types: type 1, type 2, and gestation diabetes and other types. Type 1, it is due to this autoimmune cause, it is destruction of the pancreatic beta cells. So it needs only, the management is only by insulin only. Oral drugs is not useful. The second one is type 2 diabetes. So it is more of, it's a lifestyle disease. It is due to pancreatic beta cell deficiency and also insulin resistance, more of insulin resistance. So many causes are there, obesity and hereditary causes. For example, genetic causes, both parents are diabetes, they are more prone to develop type 2 diabetes. Now I am going to talk about prevention of diabetes mellitus. How to prevent diabetes? So there are three stages in the diabetes. There are glycemic levels. One is normal, the second one is pre-diabetes, the third one is diabetes. So in the normal, that is HbA1c below 5.7. The pre-diabetes, the HbA1c is between 5.7 and 6.4. The HbA1c more than 6.4 means it is type 2 diabetes. The prevention of diabetes is should be carried out in the period of pre-diabetic stage. So if they are following our lifestyle changes, diet and exercise very meticulously, we can prevent in the development of type 2 diabetes. How to prevent? So how to prevent means, so if the one person is overweight, we have to reduce the excess weight. The second one is eat healthy, have a low calorie diet, eat a variety of foods and vegetables, drinking more water. And third one is exercise regularly, avoid instances of physical inactivity. Then the next one is reduce stress level. Then sound sleep, we should sleep at least 7 hours in a week. Then quit smoking, if you are smoking, we should quit smoking. Now I am going to talk about diabetes and pregnancy. So it is of, there are for two types. Pregnancy occurs in diabetic patients. That is called diabetes in pregnancy. So another one is called gestational diabetes. Gestational diabetes means that normal individuals, they develop diabetes during pregnancy. So management is always more of insulin. suggestion. Sulfonylurea should be avoided. Metformin we can use, and insulin is the drug of choice. Insulin can be used twice a day or once a day. That insulin, that target blood sugar level, fasting should be around 100 and postprandial should be around 130. So complications, if the sugar is uncontrolled during pregnancy, many complications may occur. For example, fetus size may be very big, so there will be difficulty in delivery. And other complications, if the sugar is not under control, some infections may occur. It leads to so many complications. So the diabetes should be under control during the whole period of pregnancy. Now I am going to talk about the lifestyle modification in the management of diabetes. So lifestyle means, changes means, the first one is diet control, the second one is exercise, the third one is stress management. These three are very important. Diet is a balanced diet, balanced healthy diet. The ideal diet should be, the carbohydrate should be 50% of our whole diet, protein 25% and fat 25%. This is the ideal balanced diet. Second one is exercise. So 30 minutes of exercise, that is aerobic exercise, is very important. Brisk walking or jogging or swimming for 30 minutes per day, at least 5 days in a week. This is the exercise. The third one is stress management. Stress management is also very important. So that, for that we can do yoga, meditation and also walking.